Hey guys, welcome back to the Parsing JSON and Java tutorial. Let's jump right in. Okay, so you remember that over here we left this object mapper with no configurations yet? Let me just show you a quick example of why we need them. Let's add a new attribute here. So let's call this author. And I'll escape the quotes. Colon, say my name, Hui. Okay, let's run this now. If we run it now, yeah, there is a field that exists on the JSON source, but can't be mapped to the Pojo. Yeah, this is a bit annoying, and most of the times you really don't want this because you don't know, you might be consuming a JSON from an API that can get updated and have a new field added to it that you really don't want. Or even if there are multiple fields over there and you really don't want to map them all because you don't need them for whatever purpose you are consuming that JSON for. So one way that we do this to avoid having this problem is we'll just go over here to the default object mapper. I call that method and I give it the configure, and it's going to be the serialization feature. And I'm going to say fail on unknown properties false. I'll just set it like this. As you can see, there are plenty of them over here. Minimize. And it's probably something that you'll take a look at some point if you are using Jackson to play around with JSON. And let's just test this out now. So no problem now. Everything works, even though there is a new field, a new property over there that cannot be mapped to our Pojo. So now we have the JSON to Pojo parsing done. Now we're going to do it the other way around. But to do that, we'll split it in two stages. First, we're going to convert a Pojo into a JSON node, and then from the JSON node, we're going to convert it to a string. So to start off, we are going to create a method that is going to be called toJSON. So public static, it's going to return a JSON node toJSON, and it's going to take in an object of some sort. We'll call it A. And we are going to use the object mapper, and I'm going to do a write to tree. Yeah? Sorry, value to tree. And give this. So. And let's test it out. I'll create this test method. Let's annotate it with a test annotation, and now we create a Pojo like we would. But now instead of creating it from a JSON node, I'm going to create it from scratch like that. I'm going to give it a title, testing 1, 2, 3, and I'm going to grab my JSON util class. I'm going to call toJSON and pass the Pojo in. And I'm going to end up with a JSON node, like so. And now we do the assert true. This, get the title, and it should be testing 1, 2, 3. Let's give it a run and see what happens. Nice. So it played out perfectly. So when we have the node, like we do over here, we need to convert it now to a string. So for that we use an object writer, which is part of the Jackson as well. So we'll write another method. It's going to be static, returning a string. I'm going to say stringify, like so. I'm going to give it a JSON node. And now I'm going to use the object writer. writer like that. I'm going to get it from the object mapper, get writer like this. Yeah. And now I'm just going to do write object writer dot write value as string like that and give it a node. I'm going to return the string like this. Have the exception to the method. Let's test it as well. Void the annotation so that I don't forget. And I'm going to use the same as we did before, like this. Now I'm going to say json.stringify. Node. Now I'm going to do system print, system out print, just to see what happens, and the format that it came out as. And I'm going to add this exception to the method signature as well. Let's run. In the stringify, we've got title testing 1, 2, 3. Now the stringify method that we have over here, that we are using, this one, we can actually make it do some other stuff, yeah? So, for example, if we want to, like this is perfect. It's already returning a string that can be passed in and out of JSON, so it's perfect. But sometimes to read, yeah, to make it visual and to debug messages and stuff, it's good to make it more readable, not a single line. Imagine that's just for one attribute. If we had many, imagine how big that would be. Yeah. So we call this one pretty print. Yeah. It's exactly like before, but now on the object writer, yeah, we're going to say that the object writer is with, and I'm going to give it some serialization feature dot indent output, like so. Yeah, it's looking good now. So pretty print, let's test it out. We'll use the same method now. So the exact same thing. Let's give it a run. So yeah, the first one is just one line. The second one, it's got indentation and all that. It breaks the line, so it's more readable, like so, yeah. So we have now these two methods. Let's just make it nicer, okay. Let's create a, because they both return strings and they both use the same object writer. So we might as well just create this. Make it private, call it generate string, and say, give it a boolean here, boolean, pretty. If it is pretty, we'll do that. We'll set the output. Now we just say generate string node, false. This and the same for this, in fact. But instead of that, we'll give it a true. And that's good. So there you have it. We have a good utils class, which is based on the one that's used on the play framework that can be used to basically read JSON into files, into Pojos, get those Pojos into JSON strings again, and work with and generate the JSON nodes intermediate object so that you can traverse the object through the tree. Like in case you don't know what the Pojo should look like because you don't know what some web service is returning. You just use JSON node and you use that to read the response from the server. So I hope everything went well. I hope you understood everything that went on in here. If there are any questions, drop them in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe. I'll see you in the next video.